Hi guys, I'm here today to meet our head of design, Oliver Stefani, to take him for a spin in the Enyaq Coupe IV. So let's see where Oliver is.
Oh wow, okay.
Olli.
Thomas, good morning.
Morning, here's where you're hiding out.
Yes, yeah, it's one of the nicest places. I love this place.
What a view from here.
Yeah,
wow.
You can see everything. You see the castle, the Charles Bridge, you know.
National Theater.
Dancing house over there. Super nice.
Impressive, so, but I've got an at least as an impressive view to show you.
Really?
So when you come along.
Okay.
On three, one, two, three.
Oh, Olli. Okay, that went wrong.
Olli, we have to do it together, okay? So on three, one, two, three.
See, that's how you do it. Huh? I learned that on TikTok.
So let's go.
So Olli, tell me about the design approach. Now, what did you guys have in mind when you created this vehicle?
Yeah, to work on this coupe was really something special because you don't do so many coupes at Škoda. We're more family-oriented, functional and spacious, yeah? So this was really something very, very enjoyable for us.
So what was the biggest challenge in it?
We were facing, of course, a lot of carryover parts. Yeah, like of course the taillights and doors, the front doors, and to incorporate this in with this new coupe line was one of the challenges.
You see the Charles Bridge? You see?
Oh yeah, that's beautiful. Especially also today in the sunlight, it's good.
Castle on top.
Yeah, not too many people on the Charles Bridge these days.
And what is your favorite angle of the car?
I like this rear three-quarter view, you know, when you really see how the short overhangs from the MEB platform, yeah? Mm-hmm. You see the big wheels and the...
Big wheels, very important for design.
Yeah, exactly. They can never be too big, you know. And then you see the roof line and how the roof line sits on the body. You see the shoulder on the rear, yeah?
Yeah.
So the car looks very dynamic from this point of view.
So I know that you're a big Star Wars fan. Huh? What does it mean for you in your life, and what's the approach of that? What does it mean for creativity?
Well, I'm Star Wars film since I'm a kid, you know. I saw the movies in the theater and it was really amazing. Yeah? It's a global phenomenon. Yeah? But also from the professional point of view, I really like Star Wars because there's so much creativity in this, in these movies, you know, to create some worlds, some design language, you know, so all these spaceships, all these creatures, you know, all these details, you know.
It was mind-blowing at the time, yeah.
It is amazing, you know, and it's always on the cutting edge what kind of technologies they're using, you know. And these people are really artists, you know, so super creative people, super artistic people. And they...
So you use this then in the lines and the vision for this vehicle?
Yeah, sometimes we take something out of these movies and say, hey, let's do it like this, yeah? And to motivate ourselves, yeah? And it's really stimulating and a fantastic world, you know, to dive in and to have fun with this and to be creative, you know?
Now look at this, heck of a view, huh?
That is beautiful, I have to say. That
I think
is
it's the
really
best
nice
view of Prague. Yeah. See everything.
Wow.
Yeah?
But you know what? I'm missing my coffee.
Oh, come on. Hang on.
Thomas, Jesus, that's amazing. Thank you.
That's what we do.
Wow.